the criminal, brain dead, incompetent President Joe Biden is still on the loose. As of today, he's pressuring Israel to cave in with regard to Hamas and Iran. Our troops have been attacked over 70 times. He does little to nothing about it. As I said yesterday, it's clearly Iranians either bribed him or have a dossier on him, Hunter Biden, James Biden, and the entire family, and are blackmailing him. This is what we're dealing with right now. Let's shift focus. The House of Representatives. The new House Speaker, Mike Johnson. I sent him a petition a few weeks ago. I said, we have convicted Biden. We have sentenced Biden to 20 years. This is the people of the United States. It's a citizen's court. Send the Capitol Police to arrest him. If I don't hear from him, if I don't hear from the new speaker within a few days, I will be petitioning all law enforcement in this country to take action. All the sheriffs, all the police departments, and everyone else. Clearly, there's a patriot here that peacefully and legally will take him into custody and put him in the prison where he belongs. There's more than enough proof to arrest him, even if there wasn't an indictment and a conviction. Even under the laws of District of Columbia, the most leftist of all places in the United States, very far Democrat and left, there's a law that says that if you know of someone who committed a felony, you can have them arrested and turn them over to law enforcement. We can't leave this guy in office anymore. He is a threat, not just to conservatives, people of faith, and those who believe in the vision and creation of our founding fathers, but even the left now views him as a threat because he's dragging them down the drain with his incompetency and destruction of this country. This is my message for today. The American people have to wake up. As I write in my book, It Takes a Counter-Revolution, Wake Up America, which you can get at freedomwatchusa.org. We are right at the edge of going under, of falling over the cliff where this country will no longer exist. We're very close to a nuclear holocaust with what's going on with regard, not just in the Middle East, but in Ukraine, and with regard to communist China, Taiwan, North Korea, and the rest. We've got terrorists running across our border. There are Hezbollah cells in South America. Clearly, they're here in the United States. It's just a matter of weeks, if not months, till we have a major terrorist attack in this country. Make no mistake about it. We are living on the edge. And that's the theme of today. And if the American people don't wake up, because our history has always been, whether it's Pearl Harbor, whether it's anything else, that we go asleep, 9/11, sitting on the desk of George W. Bush was an internal intelligence report which predicted 9/11 in effect. Let us not go through what could be the so-called final solution, to use a catchphrase of Hitler, for all the people, not just Jewish people, but also Christians, everyone, every faith, every American, every person, every man, every woman, God knows what else as people categorize themselves these days. But we are all under this cloud, and we better wake up. Our politicians do not serve us. They are not here for the American people. They're here for themselves. They become rich as they come to Washington, D.C. They think they're above the law. They scratch each other's backs, Democrats and Republicans, and the American people are left behind and at risk. Please go to freedomwatchusa.org. Contribute to our cause. We are your Justice Department. You have no Justice Department in terms of government. It's run by a despot by the name of Merrick Garland, who is more like the Fuhrer than he is a leader of the people of our legal system. Our legal system, frankly, is the most corrupt of all professions in the United States. I can tell you this as a lawyer of 46 years. It is bankrupt. The judges do not represent the American people, generally speaking. They represent themselves as well. And we have no legal recourse. And therefore, we have to turn to ourselves to enforce the rule of law. And again, I'm going to attach the trailer from Wyatt Earp. You can't see it enough, because these people that are in the streets are coming for you. And you are at risk. Your family's at risk. Your loved ones are at risk. And I hate to give you this dire message, but it's so you wake up before it's too late. Go to freedomwatchusa.org, contribute with tax-deductible contributions, and do it before it's too late, because we need to be your protector. God bless you. God bless America. Remember, the Father and Son will only help us if we help ourselves. Thank you for listening to me. I'll be back tomorrow, or perhaps even later today, as events unfold in this very fragile, dangerous world, with another podcast.
Is there going to be a fight, Wyatt?
I think there must be.
I got to tell you something, Wyatt. I told your brothers when they went off to fight, and I suppose the time's come for you. You know, I'm a man that believes in the law. After your family, it's about the only thing you got to believe in. But there are plenty of men who don't care about the law. Men who will take part in all kinds of viciousness, don't care who gets hurt. When you find yourself in a fight with such viciousness, hit first if you can. And when you do hit, hit to kill.
Give you children. We'll make our own place where no one will find us. And I won't die on you.
I'm dead anyway. So if you want to go out in a blaze of glory, I'm with you.
The closer you keep your family, the better. Nothing counts so much as blood. The rest are just strangers.